Bitcoin and real estate will be the future. With the amount of money that the Fed is printing, the inflation is going to be going through the roof. So you have to invest in assets. And if you don't invest in these four assets that I'm going to tell you about, you will be left behind. This is Austin Rutherford here, where we talk business, finance, and real estate. So the Fed just came out with a new stimulus bill that they're going to be putting into effect. And past that, they said that they might put something in place that does not have an end date yet. This could be absolutely disastrous. No end date on a stimulus bill. You can't just continue to print money. There's a store of value. Well, there was a store of value in the dollar. But when you continue to print it time and time again, that store of value goes down. The belief in it goes down. 1/3 of the money in the US was printed in 2020, roughly. So that means that 1/3 of things are worth less. So if you have $100,000 in the bank, in theory, it's only worth $67,000 now. If you own a house, in theory, if it's worth 100 grand, it just went up to $133,000. Again, I don't think it's that drastic, but that's the type of money that we're printing. And that's the negative effect to stimulus is and inflation and the government printing money, is that it has an effect on the value of a dollar bill. And it has an effect on asset classes. So the way that you're gonna get rich during this time is by owning assets. The more money that you print, the more the values go up. So the stock market is almost at an all-time high. Real estate booming right now. Bitcoin going crazy right now. It's because they're printing so much money. When you print more money, people have more money to spend and it inflates. But it's not real inflation. That's the catch here. It's not growth of something. It's just because there's more money in the market. The more money you put in, the higher things go. So my four investments that I'm putting a lot of my money into and that I definitely recommend you putting a lot of money into, we're going to be going over now. And stay tuned to the last one, because the last one is one of my favorites and I'm pretty sure it's going to change the game going forward. So the first asset class is real estate. I'm obviously a big believer in real estate. I own over a $10 million rental portfolio. I flipped over 200 houses. Obviously a believer in real estate, but owning an asset, owning real estate is one of the first things that you want to do, especially in today's market. Real estate has created more millionaires than anything else ever has. You know, that may change in the future. And like I said, wait till number four, which I think will change that. But right now, real estate is a great asset to own. It's not going anywhere. You know, land is here. They're not building any more land unless Elon Musk can land on Mars and create a whole city up there, or country up there. Until then, we're here. There's no more land coming. And if you look at a graph over time, the values of real estate have slowly gone up. There's ups and downs, but over time, it's gone up. So it's a great store of value and growth of value. You know, there's been houses that I flipped a year ago and I sold it for, let's say, $400,000. And the homeowners are reselling it now for almost $500,000. That's a 25% gain in 1 year. I'm not saying all markets are like that at all, but what I'm saying is the amount of money that's being printed, values have to go up. There's more money in circulation, so the values have to go up. I can give you example after example of houses that I've sold that had inflated 20, 30, 40, 50% of the value in 1 or 2 years. Again, because one, real estate is a great asset. It has always gone up in value every single year. And the amount of money that's in circulation, there's only one place for assets to go, and that's up. And the other beautiful thing about real estate is if you use leverage to own it, meaning that you get loans out. So let's say, for example, you have $100,000. Instead of buying one house for $100,000, you can buy five houses and put $20,000 down on each house and put a mortgage on all of them. And now instead of owning $100,000 in real estate, you own $500,000 in real estate. And the beautiful thing is you can lock in an interest rate for the next 10, 20, 30 years. So whatever happens in the market, interest rates go up or down. I don't think they're going down. They're already at almost the lowest point they've ever been. So in my opinion, I think interest rates are only going to continue to go up. So if you can lock in an interest rate for 10, 20, or 30 years on over $500,000 of real estate, guess what? Your interest rate's locked. The $500,000 is gonna go up in value. So, you know, a year or 2 years from now, it might be worth $550,000 or $600,000 or even $700,000, depending on what the market does and how much money the government continues to print. But you can lock in those rates and have exponential growth at times. You get the appreciation, the depreciation, the cash flow, the mortgage pay down. There's huge benefits to owning real estate. So that's my first asset class, is you have to invest in real estate. The second asset class that I believe in is the stock market. The stock market has been here for a long time, and it's not just going to disappear anytime soon. There's a lot of millionaires being made and a lot of billionaires being made in the stock market right now. When stocks crash or stocks go up, that money just doesn't like appear. Somebody is losing money and somebody's gaining money. You know, it's an exact effect on what happens. And again, with the amount of money that the Fed is printing, over 30% of new money in the market, usually because the stock market, you can buy in at an entry level price, real estate you need money to own. The stock market you can buy in with $50 or $1 or $500,000. Usually all of that extra money floats back to the stock market. So if we just printed 30% more money, guess where it's going to be? The stock market. The stock market is going to continue to rise as well because there's simply more money in circulation. More money in circulation, the higher the price goes. So as it goes up, you need to ride that wave. You need to get in on it. Now there are risks in the stock market because companies can go file for bankruptcy, you know, things like that. Real estate's a hard asset that's not going anywhere. But if you have some more money sitting around, put it into the stocks because stocks are going up right now. It's almost at an all-time high. In 3 days back in March, the stock market plummeted, crashed entirely in 3 days. And since then, we've already made that back and we're growing past that now as well. And especially because the Fed just released last week another stimulus plan, people that invest in the stock market have more confidence. So they're going to continue to put more money in the stocks. It's going to continue to go up. So real estate, stocks. The third thing that I recommend is gold. Now, Robert Kiyosaki has been saying gold and silver forever. He said that he's bought an immense amount of gold that he has just in storage right now because gold is one of the most rare things to find. So if it's the lowest in supply and the demand's high, the price is going to go up. And the demand's high is because people are losing faith in the fiat currency of the US government, which is the dollar bill. So when people lose faith in the dollar bill, they need to put their money into investments or they need to hedge their risk and buy assets, real estate, stocks, gold and silver. See, the US dollar was taken off of the gold standard back in 1971, and it was only meant to be a temporary thing when they took it off the gold standard. But if you look back, we've never been back to the gold standard. We've always been off of it for the last 49 years. But the value of gold has gone up over those last 45 years. So most people believe that gold is a great investment and a great store of value that will continue to appreciate again because the supply is so low. You can't just go out and pick up gold from the street. You have to like dig a mine, invest hundreds of millions of dollars just to get to the gold and hope that you find it. So the supply is low, the demand is high, price goes up. And number four, this is gonna surprise some of you, and this is what I believe it will be the biggest growth into the future. And let me explain why I believe that before I tell you what it is. Gold is one of the most finite things to find. Like I said, you can't just go out and find gold. You gotta invest millions of dollars to create mines to go down into the earth and hopefully find gold. But the thing with gold is we don't know the supply, but tomorrow somebody can hit the biggest gold mine ever and then the supply will go up. So the prices might come down a little bit. You know, I don't think it's going to change that much, but gold is the most finite thing in the world and that's why there's value to it. Now, this next thing I'm going to tell you is the only thing in the world that's more finite than gold. If there's one thing in the world that's more finite than gold, in my opinion, it's gonna go up in value. So let me tell you what that is. That thing is called Bitcoin. And I know some of you guys are gonna call me crazy, but I believe that this is one of the things that'll grow massively into the future. So the thing with Bitcoin is that there's only 21 million Bitcoins that'll ever be out in circulation. And there's 18.5 of those Bitcoins out right now. And over the coming years, they're gonna finish putting out those last 2.5 million coins. But after that, there will never be any more coins. 21 million coins, that's it. The supply will never change. So think about this. Apple is worth $2 trillion. That's just one company, $2 trillion, let alone all the other stocks in the entire stock market. Apple is worth $2 trillion. The entire crypto market, the entire market, which Bitcoin is just one of those things in the entire market, in January of 2020 was only $237 billion, not even half of $1 trillion. Apple was worth $2 trillion. The entire market is worth way more than that. The crypto market is only worth $237 billion as of January 2020. As I said, Bitcoin has a finite supply. When supply is steady and demand goes up, guess what happens? Price goes up. And all around the world, people are starting to accept it. Credit card companies, banks, Coinstar machines, those are all starting to be able to turn money into Bitcoin. So I'm gonna explain what crypto is because I didn't understand it at the beginning here in a second. But like I said, people are losing faith in the fiat currency of the US dollar, because if there's a value of a dollar bill and then somebody is able to just print more money, just print it, the confidence in that currency goes down because it doesn't have a store of value anymore. You know, let's say there's, and this is not the right number, but let's say there's $100 million out there, and then all of a sudden somebody prints another $100 million, and now you got $200 million. The value goes down because that dollar is not worth what it was once worth. So people are looking for other places to invest that money now. So to explain what crypto is, which I was very confused when I first started learning about this, I thought crypto was Bitcoin. That's not what it is. So crypto is like the stock market. So the cryptocurrency market is like a stock market. Bitcoin is just like one company in the crypto market, just like Apple is one company in the stock market. And there's a lot of other quote unquote coins in the crypto market. Now, for the most part, this is not 100%, but for the most part, Bitcoin in the crypto market is the one that is seen at having a dollar value to the coin. So people use Bitcoin for purchases, just like people use the US dollar for purchases. And like I said, there's a lot of other coins in here, like Ethereum, XRP, Polkadot, like a whole bunch of other things in here. And those are basically other businesses under the crypto market. So again, when I first started, I had a hard time understanding that process. Crypto is like stocks, Bitcoin is like Apple. And if you've been watching the crypto market, it has been exploding. Bitcoin just passed its previous all-time high last week. So previously it almost hit 20 grand and then tanked tremendously. Now we're past $20,000. It's right now when I'm filming this video, it's about $23,000, $24,000. Some people even project Bitcoin hitting $100,000 by the end of 2021. So if you put 25 grand in a year, it's gonna turn into 100 grand. That's a 300% return on your investment. Now there's some people saying that these other coins like Chainlink, like XRP, like Ethereum, could 1,000x. So if you put $1,000 into one of these other coins, it could potentially turn into $1 million. That's the type of potential that the crypto market has, and that's why I believe in it so much. And if you really wanna know, I think crypto will create more millionaires than we've ever seen before. And I'm gonna tell you this, the last thing you wanna do when the government's printing all types of money is keep your money in a bank account or not invested, because every dollar they print, the value of the US dollar goes down, every single dollar. And they're printing a ton of money right now, so the value is continuing to go down. So don't keep your money in a bank account. You need to have that money invested into assets like real estate, like stocks, like crypto, like gold. Those are the assets that will grow in value as the government prints money. Don't get left behind, because the world is gonna move on with or without you. The money being printed, values are gonna go up. Have your money invested so you can ride the wave along with all the other people. And like I said, one of the greatest stores of value that you can invest in right now is real estate. So if you check this video out, it's gonna show you exactly how you can buy your first rental property. So comment below, let me know what your thoughts are, if you believe what I believe. And while you're down there, make sure you smash that like button. YouTube loves that algorithm, that'd be greatly appreciated. As always, thank you for being here, and we'll see you on the next one.